Hillary Rodham Clinton.
Welcome back to the program. Hillary Clinton, sexism, and the press. She says the media perpetuates a double standard for women. It's a powerful charge coming from the woman who could well be the Democratic nominee for president in 2016. Listen to what she said Thursday night at the Women in the World Conference in New York.
There is a double standard, obviously. We have all either experienced it or at the very least seen it. And I think in many respects, the media is the principal propagator of its persistence. And I think the media needs to be, you know, more self-consciously aware of that.
Listen to the applause she received for that. She's touching on something that everybody has an opinion about. And it's illuminating to hear her critique the media specifically. We all recall the heat she took when her husband ran for office in the early 1990s and when he was president. Remember this from the campaign trail?
I suppose I could have stayed home and baked cookies and had teas, but what I decided to do was to fulfill my profession, which I entered before my husband was in public life.
There were hundreds of stories about that, days of coverage, and some women who were offended by it. And then there was the hair. The press covered her hairstyles obsessively when she was first lady, and Mrs. Clinton has spoken of how frustrating it was when she was trying to do important work. But what about now? Are there examples of Hillary Clinton being held to the double standard she described? Does she benefit from speaking openly about this? Joining me now to talk about this is CNN's newest political analyst, Maggie Haberman. She's a senior political reporter for Politico. Do you think there's truth in what she's saying about a double standard?
I think that historically there it is hard to look at sort of her, for instance, when she talks about the hair issue. She has over the years talked about the focus on her hair. It started when she was in the White House, but when she ran for Senate in New York, there was very heavy emphasis on it and on her clothes and how she dressed. And she has said in the past, other people have said in the past, you know, you would not see a man or a male politician get the same kind of attention. It does seem that things have shifted a bit where she could even talk about this so openly. You would not have seen her address this, as I said, so openly in 2008, but certainly there is a history there.
She could have dodged it, right? She could have sized up it if she wanted to.
Absolutely. She could have not gone near it. She could have said, yes, but things are changing. She could have answered in any number of ways. She answered it very specifically, and I think that it speaks to two things. I think it speaks to something she believes, and I think it speaks to the fact that if she does run for the presidency again, she is going to speak very openly about gender. She's going to speak very openly to issues that impact women. She has been doing that, but I think this really brought it to a different level.
As a political reporter, have you witnessed examples of this double standard in your coverage of Hillary Clinton over the years?
I mean, I think, as I said, when I was covering her when she was first in the Senate in 2000, and certainly when she was running for that campaign, there was a lot of attention on looks, on clothes, on appearance. There was a sense that a male politician would not get the same kind of coverage. That's not universally true, by the way. I mean, there certainly has been coverage over the years of Rudy Giuliani's weight, for instance, by the New York tabloids. New York is a bit of a different market in terms of this. New York has a very heavy tabloid market, as you know. There's going to be more aggressive focus on certain aspects. But Hillary Clinton has a credible case that there have been focus on appearance where she's concerned, where you may not see that with a male politician.
At the event, she quoted Eleanor Roosevelt, didn't she? She was saying the women who want to be involved in public life have to grow skin like a rhino.
Yeah,
but I would think some younger women, some younger people would say, is that still true? Is that the case? Or is Hillary Clinton reflecting the generation she grew up in?
Well, her argument was that it's still the case and that essentially there are still attitudes that have to be changed for young women in general as they want to rise in the world, was the way Tom Friedman, the moderator of that panel, asked the question. And it was not just about media. It was not just about public life. It was just about life in general. Her point was that you can take that Eleanor Roosevelt point and extrapolate it for both an outside voice and an inside voice, that women need to be mindful in a way that men don't of connecting on a certain level with people that they're trying to convince of their own opinion of their own ideas, but that the inside voice and taking criticism, as she put it, seriously, not personally, is equally important.
So assuming she does run for president, do you think journalists will be conscious of this charge? Will they keep this in mind? Should they?
I think that we will see how it goes. I think that how she gets covered as a presidential candidate in 2016, if she runs, compared to how she was in 2008, will be one of the great stories to cover.
Maggie Haberman, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.